This is the WZRD News. As Chicago grapples with how to feed and shelter migrants now arriving daily, food pantries have stepped up to fill a void that some blame on the city's failure to adequately prepare for the surge in hungry newcomers. Already stretched thin by increased demand and rising inflation, pantries now face the challenge of feeding and caring for migrants seeking help at their doors. The city has said more than 8,000 migrants have come to Chicago over the past 12 months, with nearly 100 arriving daily. While pantries do not keep data on how many migrants they feed every week, they do count new guests. Kellie O'Connell, CEO of Nourishing Hope, said the pantry's number of new clients doubled in the fiscal year ended March 31st, rising to 22,000 from 11,000 in the prior fiscal year. She said that because of the surge in demand, which is not only because of migrants, but also the reduction in federal food benefits and rising inflation, they have had to put a cap on clients at the Humboldt Park location. We get calls daily from different police stations or community groups to help support with food because they're not getting what they need, O'Connell said. The city said it was working with the vendor Open Kitchens on feeding migrants throughout the emergency shelter system, providing new arrivals with 3 meals a day. The city said it has also partnered with the Greater Chicago Food Depository to provide 3 meals a day, snacks and other essential items to all 3 respite facilities. Pantries say stepped-up contributions from donors have enabled them to largely keep pace with rising demand, but they worry that donations eventually will fall short if the crisis continues. Already, some have started rationing food and limiting guest capacity to stretch their budgets. Alderman Byron Cicho Lopez, 25th, says former Mayor Lori Lightfoot was caught unprepared by the volume of migrants, which has resulted in the need for nonprofits to step in. With police stations and other city-run shelters at maximum capacity, he said community members and nonprofits have had to step up to fill those gaps. As the former mayor scrambled for resources to cope with hundreds more asylum seekers arriving here from border states, she declared a state of emergency, which seemed to catch her successor flat-footed. Newly elected Mayor Brandon Johnson saw a $51 million budget amendment to help care for asylum seekers blocked from a vote until the next city council meeting set for May 31st. The amendment earmarks $5.6 million for meals, while the bulk of it, around $35 million, would be spent on contract staffing to facilitate the initial reception of new arrivals, coordinate contacts, and staff temporary shelters. According to CBS Chicago, the city has been spending $20 million a month to care for migrants, with that figure expected to increase. The city recently received $4.3 million from the Federal Emergency Management Agency's Emergency Food and Shelter Program, far less than the $38.9 to $66.7 million local officials requested. In total, FEMA allocated $332.5 million to 35 local governments. New York got the largest award, $30.5 million. Source: Crane's Chicago Business, May 26th, 2023.